scratches, you know, deer or close, you know.
Ready? Every good restaurant needs a signature dish.
We'll look like dicks now.
I'm going to use their venison to create a modern version of bangers and mash.
I'm going to make some sausages now, yes?
Yep. Sachet of venison, go on.
Yes, some cranberries. A few apricots.
Yep.
A nice mixed spice. Not a fucking bucket in size. Now for the easy part.
Yes,
sausage skin.
I'm going to fucking turn that me hard. Did he'll catch the fucker?
Oh, shit.
Oh,
let's not start arguing over the size of that sausage.
We've now got our signature dish for our new distinctive menu. And getting out of the kitchen has proved to be a real tonic for Richie.
He's brought me up here and I can feel a bit more enthusiasm to say, look, I've been to this place, I want to cook. And I'll try and make him proud, you know what I mean? Because I can see, he can see something in me, you know, which I really appreciate, you know, because nobody fucking has for years, you know what I mean?
Can I now inspire country boy Mick down in Devon to start cooking real food rather than ready meals?
Oakhampton is screaming out for really good neighbourhood, family-run, small, intimate bistro. But before we can get any of that started, these guys need to go back to basics, cooking fresh ingredients.
I'm determined to put some honesty back onto the Dovecote menu and get Mick out of cash and carry and into his local butcher.
If I'm eating in your restaurant and I know that you've sourced it locally as a local butcher, the quality is second to none.
What do you want?
Are you doing that?
Yeah.
Brilliant. The difference between a cash and carry and local butcher, it's night and day, and we can cut off whatever you like. A bistro is about the cheek cuts, about the rumps, about the bone shoulders, about the belly.